Chris Isaak. Can you welcome him?
Thank you. Chris, I just don't know if I'm loved here. So I'm hoping that after the show, if somebody's got just an extra hug. You're coming back, Jim. We're going to play some new songs tonight, some old songs, and at the end we'll play everything we know.
I'm Oh,
I'm glad to just talk to you a little bit about show business. For all I know, I might be the only person you know personally who is in show business. And tonight, what I'd like to discuss, just put it under this heading, from the old words of this song, this kind of wraps up the whole, there were bells in the sky, but I never heard them ringing. No, I never heard them at all. Is that you who did that thing?
I saw
Chuck
Berry.
I know you did. You know, you would think that being on the road and being in show business and moving from town to town, you might think that we have all kinds of wild things going on and stuff, but let me tell you something. For us, yeah, it's true, actually, we do have a lot of wild stuff. Actually, it's this very club that I began to learn just the kind of hijinks that one can get into if one lets oneself. It was in this club that I saw and first learned about a thing which probably everybody here knows about. Because like, right below where you're sitting, about in 1967 or 68, there was a slot car track. Down below where you are, you used to go in there and you could race slot cars, and they still have the whole area down there. And I went and I was looking before the show, I was walking around down there just looking, and I'm looking for my bass player and my drummer, because punctuality is part of my thing. I feel I owe you that and a shiny suit. So I go down and I'm like, I find the bass player and I got, everybody's together and I can't find my guitar player, and I'm looking around and finally, I'm looking down into where the slot car track used to be, and I'm down there about, well, maybe 20 minutes looking around through stuff, I can't find it. And I start to head up, and just as I start to head up, I heard a little noise in the distance. Just a wee, little petite noise. And it sounded like exactly like this. They were a member of the Elks Club, almost. And I wouldn't have pushed open a door that was shut. It was slightly ajar. And so I opened it up, and I looked inside, and I saw something that changed me. I think it added additional chest hairs to me. I became hirsute. Did I say that word? Anyway, I opened up the door and I looked inside and I saw my guitar player was there with a woman who I've been looking out. I can't, is there any more light for the audience? I would like to actually point her out if I could see her. She's, I don't know if she's here. She was about this tall. But she had on like these big kind of like stiletto high heels that made her about like this tall. And she was wearing kind of a leatherette mini dress thing. It wasn't actually a mini dress. It was like if you had some leatherette at your house, and like say one weekend you started to make a dress out of leatherette, and then you had a little bit of leatherette left, and you didn't have any plans, and you just sitting around, and so suddenly you felt handy. And you said, hey, I've got enough leatherette left over, let me try to make one more dress. That's what she was wearing, was like, and it was constricting her and confining her in ways that were hurting me. She would look down. She was standing up, and she was, although she was tiny, she was statuesque. You do the math. And I saw this all in about 10 seconds. She had a little like kind of a whip. But it's on the whip. This is the interesting, I've seen whips before in photographs. But this thing on the whip, it actually said Tandy Leather Corporation. Yeah, so you knew it was good quality stuff. And she would look down and my guitar player was laying on the couch dabbing up Devon Settee kind of occasional piece, and she'd look down and she would go, Jimmy Wilson? Just like, I'm trying to become her. Oh well, I forget it. That's dangerous, isn't it? She would look down and she would go, she said, Jimmy Wilson? Jimmy, you shall be my lover. Scared, that's what he did. He would kind of flinch like that, but at the same time he flinched, he did something. See, that's okay to flinch, but he did this too. He'd go,
ooh, Papa's been a bad boy.
I did what any one of you probably would have done. If you'd been in my shoes. Spartan. I think I called you a Spartan, man. I walked in there and said, Jimmy, man, I said, what's going on? Is this woman like causing you pain? Is she doing something to you? Can I help? And he looked at me, he sat up, pulling himself together from his akimbo position. And it was akimbo, Jim. And he looked, he said, Chris, you know, everybody here at San Juan Capistrano knows what's going on in this room. And everybody in the band understands this. Father Junipero Sierra even wrote about this with the Europeans. All that's happening here is why. Stand and whisper, oh. Yeah. like that segue. Before there were supermarkets, people would actually, there was a guy, like a tinker or a tailor, there was a guy who would go from town to town in a little wagon or an old Pinto, and he had no tools except for those he had nature given him, and he would bring to the women folk satisfaction in its most primitive form. And this man was known simply, in the old days, as a diddly daddy. During the song, if you'd like to look at my guitar player and just imagine maybe that you're his father and yell out like the old diddlies, they would yell this as they would drive. You're not buying this at all, are you? Good. Have you seen the act before? Don't spoil it for others, please. Come on. As the diddly would drive by the houses, they would yell, you know, and they would yell, "Bee bye, Bicky bye, go, go, go." You ready, Jimmy?
What?
Diddly, diddly, daddy. Hit it up.
Better to hear it, Sam, all the same.
Fly back to Capistrano. That's the day, my darling, you return to me. Swallows fly by to Capistrano. That's the day, my darling.
I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce a man perhaps best known for his rap hits. And some of you might remember him way back in the 70s. He did it several times. He was on the Loco. Ready? Let's have the music for him now. A big hand, a huge hand. Really just, I mean, ludicrously huge hand for Mr. Aaron Gregory Zodiac! How's everything in Mount Pilot, man? Whose birthday is it today? Is it somebody's birthday today?
Where's Megan?
She's 16, she's not here? Really, because Jimmy, you know, Jimmy's 17. What song would you like to do? No, you have kind of fixed yourself up for San Juan, haven't you? Yes, he has. Now, is that a kind of cinnamon or burnt orange? Is that hard to find things that are coordinated with that? Well, I'd like to go on talking to you, but it's time to play. You talk in here, the music comes out there. You ready?
Thank you.
clothes around here? I'm sorry, Kenny. Jimmy and I were having an important discussion over here. Are you tired or anything? I mean, Jimmy missed most of that solo. I was talking to him about something. We just had to pick up some personal items and thrifty there. I just want to know, can you do that drum solo again, only better? You know, bring it down, man. It's the last time, I think the last time we played here, it was either here or Modesto. No, it was here. Because I remember my drummer got really excited. And he came down and during, did you sing, you either sang, who stole the Kishka? Was that what he sang? He sang a number, right? He was playing drums and he sang, I think he sang, who stole the Kishka? Either do that, man. Either sing that or sing a Dean Martin song. And then when you're done singing, like do like Vilarich or That's Amore or something like that. And then when you're done, I want you to do this. I want you to just stand up briefly, play the drum a little bit, okay? All right, okay, write this all down. And then, and here's, and here, ladies and gentlemen, what I hope to be the capper of the evening for you. And then I want you to play the drum with your head. He did it when he first auditioned for me. When I found this guy, he was just a young, just apple-cheeked kid. He came in, he didn't have any drumsticks, and then he said, look, Mr. Isaak, I still want to be in the band. I don't have any sticks today. I'll play with my head. And at first I thought it was a gag, but he actually, come on, Kenny. Now, Dean Martin, stand up and play with your head.
Hit your eye like a big pizza pie.
You would rather go out with my guitar player than to go out with me. I, who would give you everything, including love. And you would rather go with Jimmy Wilson. Every woman that goes out with him starts talking in a high voice and walking on bowling. I think something's wrong with this mic. I think something's wrong with this mic. It's saying things it doesn't mean to say. Then as though his entire crummy life depended on it. He reached inside himself and pulled it out. clap their hands. Come on, man. Take your hands like this, man. Come on, let's not be afraid to share our love. Just gently like this. Now? Oh, man, this looks groovy like this, man. All right, take your hands now. Just gently reach to the person next to you. Begin to rub their body. It's okay. I present it. I give you permission. Rub their body up and down. Share your love experience.
Come on, baby. Come on. Different people. Come on. Different people.
to introduce that. Is there more light on this side of the stage, Victor? A good looking guy, that not only good looking, a good drummer, and a guy that kids can look up to, Kenny Dale Johnson. But I want to say that right here is proof that reform, not punish, should be the key word. I'm proud of you, Ken. What song would you like to do more than any song in the whole world right now?
Lion Sleeps Tonight. That's my desire.
Yeah, this is a slow song, and I know you're sitting down, and this is really meant for like slow dancing, but if you want, you can just kind of reach under the table and just touch one another. Okay? That's my desire.
Thank you. time now to bring up the real talent in the band. Rolling, come up here. I'm sorry, I know a lot of people are looking forward to Rolly doing the number, but I promised Jimmy a chance tonight. He's been working on this for I don't know how long. You ready? 8 months. 8 months. It's kind of a male to remain number. And Jimmy said he kept wanting to try it out on the road. He said, you know what, Chris? He says, I'd love to do a male to remain number. He says, but I know the people. And San Juan Capistrano is so close to Mexico, he says, and I am speaking Esperanto. Is this going to be the one you're going to do in Esperanto, or is this going to be the international language of Esperanto? A lot of people here do speak Esperanto. I don't speak Esperanto here, Jim. And you better go with the Tone Wolf number. Mr. James Calvin Wilson, ladies and gentlemen, doing his rendition of the ever-popular Wild Thing.
Wild thing, come on, come on, come on, come on.
get up here and just sock it to me one day.
Oh, And my bracelet where you signed it last night. Okay. Okay.